Welcome to Beacon High School online video. Topic for today is the moon and eclipses. According to the fairy tale, the moon is a most beautiful place, but moon actually is a dry, airless and lifeless place that is made up of only rocks. So let us know about the moon. The moon is only natural satellite of the earth that revolves around the earth. The moon is the nearest celestial body to the earth and it is about 386,000 kilometers away. The moon appears to be the brightest object in the night sky, but it has no light of its own. It bounces back the sunlight falling on it. The moon is about 1/4 the size of the earth, but it appears to be the same size as the sun. As it is much smaller than the sun, this is because the moon is much closer to us than the sun. Surface of the moon. The surface of the moon is rocky and covered with dust. It has high mountains and big pits called craters. It is believed that these craters were formed when meteorites came crashing onto the surface of the moon. A meteorite is actually a natural occurring metallic or stony object. There is no atmosphere on the moon. So, the side of the moon facing the sun is very hot and the side of the moon that is away from it is very cold and there is no water. Hence, clouds are not formed. Let us study why objects feel lighter on the moon. A person standing on the moon would feel that his or her weight has reduced, and also if a stone is dropped, it would fall to the surface with a slower rate than it does on the earth. This is so because gravity at the surface of the moon is lesser than that on the earth. Now, what is gravity? Gravity is a natural pull that is exerted by the celestial body to draw the objects towards it. More the heavier the body, the more the gravity will be. Since the moon is lighter than the earth, so the gravity at the moon surface is less. So objects are not so strongly pulled as on earth. And suppose the weight of the body is 30 kg on earth, but if that weight of the body of the object is sent to the moon, it will become 5 kg. Walking on the moon. The American space mission Apollo 11 landed on the moon on July 20, 1969. It was the first of its kind launched by Kennedy Space Center at Florida, USA. It carried three astronauts, Neil Armstrong, Edwin Aldrin and Michael Collins. Among them, Neil Armstrong was the first to step on the moon. Aldrin followed him, while Collins remained in the spacecraft to keep in touch with the connecting space center on the earth. Now let us study about the Indian explorer who went into the space. Squadron leader Rakesh Sharma from India was the first Indian to go into the space. Kalpana Chawla, she was the first American woman of Indian origin to go into the space. She along with the other astronaut traveled to International Space Lab in the Space Shuttle Columbia. On February 1, that is 2003, the Space Shuttle Columbia, while returning to the Earth carrying the astronauts, exploded and burned down. Sunita Williams, an American astronaut of Indian origin, was the first woman to stay in space for 193 days. The largest stay recorded so far. Phases of the moon. Moon has no light of its own. It shines only because of the sunlight bouncing back off its surface. The moon revolves around the earth, so we see portion of it lit up by the sun at different times in a month. Thus, moon appears to change shape when, in fact, it is only partially lit up by the sun. This apparent changing shapes of the moon during the month are called phases of the moon. Phases of the moon depends upon the position of the moon with respect to the earth and the sun. In the diagram, sunlight is shown coming from the sun and the earth is at the center. The larger outer circles in the diagram shows the images of the moon that we see from the earth at a particular time of the month. Here only 8 important stages are shown. Moon revolves around the earth and the inner circle, it shows that one half of the moon is always lit up by the sun as it is facing towards the sun. And other part of the moon that is not facing towards the sun appears dark that we look from the earth. Now, new moon. New moon is a phase when we cannot see the moon at all from the earth because its dark side face us. It is full moon when fully lit face of the moon is visible to us, so we see it as a big shiny ball. Gibbous moon is when more than half of the moon is visible, though not all of it is seen. While the moon appears to grow, we see it is waxing, and when it appears to shrink back to the new moon, it is said to be waning. The moon takes 27.3 days to complete one revolution around the earth, and it also takes the same amount of the time to spin on its own axis as well. Here in this picture, you can see how the moon changes its shape on a particular day in a month. After the new moon, the moon changes its shape into the waxing crescent and waxing gibbous, that is, the moon appears to grow into the full moon. After the full moon, the moon again shrink back to the new moon and they show the shape of waning gibbous and waning crescent. The moon and tides. Let us know what is the connection between the moon and the tides. The gravity or the gravitational pull of the moon causes rise and fall in the sea water on the earth. As the moon revolves around the earth, the surface of the earth that is facing the moon experiences the maximum gravitational pull. As the water rushes upwards on the side facing the moon, the water level at shore rises, causing high tides. It is also known as spring tide. At the same time, a high tide is also caused in the opposite direction. This is caused due to the combined effect of the rotation of the earth and the gravitational pull of the moon on the earth. Between the two high tides, ocean water level falls, causing low tides. Thus, the periodic rise and fall of the water level in large water bodies due to gravitational pull of the moon are called tides. Light and shadow. Light helps us to see. Without light, we are not able to see anything. It is a form of energy. So, depending upon whether the objects allow the light to pass through them or not, there are three types of objects: transparent object, translucent object, and opaque objects. Those objects which allow all the light to pass through them are called as transparent. For example, plain glass and cellophane paper. Here in this picture, you can see this is the transparent glass and we can see clearly the elephant picture. Now, translucent. Translucent objects are those which allow the light to pass through only partially. means it allow only some light to pass. For example, butter paper. Here you can see in this picture, there is a translucent glass where we can see only some of the images of the elephant. Now, opaque. Those objects which do not allow any light to pass through them are called opaque. For example, wood, brick and steel. In this picture, we have used this opaque objects through which we are not able to see the image of elephant. Shadow. When the path of the light is blocked by an opaque object, then shadow is formed. For example, the human beings or the man, apple, all these are opaque objects. When they block the light, then a shadow is formed on the wall. Even the trees are also act as a opaque object. So they block the view of the light of the sun and they form the shadow on the ground. Eclipse. An eclipse occurs when celestial body cast shadow on each other. There are two types of eclipse, lunar eclipse and solar eclipse. The sun, earth and the moon, they are not in perfect alignment with each other. However, sometimes they come in a straight line with the earth between the sun and the moon. When this happens, the moon is covered by the earth's shadow and so becomes dark and invisible to us from certain places on the earth. This phenomena is called lunar eclipse. Means the earth blocks the sunlight and here the earth's shadow falls on the moon. The lunar eclipse is full if the whole of the moon is darkened and it is partial only when a portion of it is covered by the earth's shadow. A lunar eclipse mostly occurs on full moon night only when the sun, earth and moon align themselves in a straight line. Solar eclipse. Sometimes the sun, the moon and the earth all lie in a straight line with the moon in between the sun and the earth. The moon blocks the sunlight reaching the earth and it casts its shadow on the earth and for a while people in certain parts of the earth cannot see the sun at all. That is total eclipse. And sometimes they can see partially. That is partial eclipse. And this phenomena is known as solar eclipse. So a solar eclipse takes place only on a new moon day. You should not view a solar eclipse directly. It may damage our eyes. Artificial satellites. Artificial satellites are man-made objects that are continuously circling around the earth or some other celestial body in space. They are launched with the help of rockets. Now let us know some uses of satellites. They are used to forecast weather, means they give early warnings of forthcoming storms, cyclones and rain. They help in telephonic communication and also in the live telecast of programs on TV. They help us to study about the outer space and galaxies. They also take pictures of the Earth so that scientists can study the Earth's surface. They assist in the navigation of ships and aircraft. They monitor crops and other resources and they also support in military activities. Some artificial satellites launched by India are Aryabhatta, Bhaskara, Rohini, Apple, INSAT-1B, INSAT-2B, IRS-1A, CARTOSAT-1. Aryabhatta was the first Indian satellite that was launched on April 19, 1975. CARTOSAT-1 was the first remote sensing satellite launched by India. The first man-made satellite launched by the USSR in 1975 was Sputnik. The Indian Space Research Organization launched the spacecraft Chandrayaan-1 on October 22, 2008. It was sent to map the moon's surface. So today we have learnt all about the moon, its surface, the phases of moon, about the lunar eclipse and solar eclipse, and about the artificial satellites.